It's a soy steak.
A soy steak? Soy sausage. Ew. Take this pretzel. That's for me. The pretzel's for me.
That's just...
I was hungry. I'm missing something here. What am I missing?
I bet it's the doormat.
The doormat? Can't...
No, it's not. Anything on the couch?
Wait, wait. It's yellow, so it's somewhere... Oh, here we go. A letter. Oh,
there's a letter.
Okay. And there's one more thing.
Oh, there to the right.
To the right? Where?
Oh, I thought it was glowing a color.
It's very helpful. Where is it?
It's under the porn mags to the left.
This? That has a pineapple on it. It's not a porn mag.
Hey, anything's a dildo if you try hard enough.
That's true.
So, where...
I mean, it is true. We see phallic things all the time. Wait, this a book? No, it's not a book. What was I thinking? Wait, this thing? What is this thing up here? Oh, got it. We
didn't even look over there.
I don't know why I didn't. All right, compare the two signatures and click on any differences found.
Oh, I love these actual, like, looking receipts. Meat Shop, your one stop for fresh meats. Check us out online, www.meatshop.com.
555 meat.
Meat.
Let's call that number. So that C is different. The L is different. The I, the dot is different. Hello. But well, it's really sensitive. It won't really let me click very well.
K and the U are not connected.
K and the U, not connected. That's right.
S is different.
S is different here. Yes. The R, there's no curly on the R.
Mm-hmm.
There is one more difference. One more difference. I think it's the E. The E is not...
Yeah, the E is curled. A little... It's curvy.
This is obviously a forged signature.
And I know.
Well, if she's stashing any sodium nitrate, she's damn good at hiding it. I've got nothing. You?
I found plenty. What were you doing? That receipt we found at the restaurant, I don't think it belongs to Claire.
What makes you say that?
Because... Look at this. The signature is completely different than the signature on this letter and this contract. Both of which have little hearts over the eyes.
You're right. Someone forged her signature on that receipt. I wonder who it could be.
Yeah, give us one, or give you one guess who that someone is.
Tom did say it was awfully convenient that the receipt just fell at his feet as he finished talking to Russell.
And Brussels does have the most to gain from Lana's illness.
Time to talk to the new chef de cuisine of Transatlantic. That's right.
It's probably just said transatlantic, but
it's. I think it's teak. It's supposed to be kind of chic sounding.
Maybe it's a transatlantic hue.
It's beautiful.
Dr. Hadley, right? And I've met you, too. I don't remember your name, because I'm not into dudes. But I'd be happy to show you our new pricks fixie menu.
I believe that's prefi.
Whatever, man.
There is one prick on this screen, and it's not the food.
Yep. Dr. Foreman, recently our colleague, Dr. Taub, was here. He found his receipt signed by Claire Kustra.
How did that receipt get on Claire's workstation?
Well, I'm gonna guess she put it there. What is all this about? You can actually tell there that it's like a weird filtered photograph.
It is, yeah, it is really weird.
It's interesting. She put it there.
It's not the worst I've ever seen, though.
No, it works. It's just sometimes you can tell. Anyway, it's a strange effect. Claire Custer put the receipt on her workstation. That's what you're telling us. It's her receipt. Got her signature on it. Right.
Okay. Thank you for your time.
One more thing. Can you sign a letter or sign a form for us? It's hospital policy. Not fishy at all.
Compare the signatures by dragging Claire's signature over Russell's and matching three similar letters. So we've got, let's see, the E maybe? No. Oh, whoops. I guess all I really have to do is...
is just wow. Really?
I guess
just drag it over.
I mean, if you really want to do it that way, you can.
It's pretty great.
Me?
If Claire signed that receipt, why does the handwriting match your handwriting on this form? What? Are you kidding me here? No, the handwriting is a perfect match. See? Looks like you forged his receipt, supposedly signed by Claire, in order to frame her for buying sodium nitrite with which you poisoned Lana. What? I hope you folks have a good lawyer, because you don't just go around accusing people like that. You're not cops. You're doctors.
Just calm down, Russell.
Oh, you better get out of here right now. You guys have no right. I'm under a lot of pressure. My boss is very sick, okay?
So, Claire bought the sodium nitrate, huh?
Okay, what do you want? I bought the sodium nitrite, all right. You happy?
Why do you keep saying nitrate?
You say nitrate, yes.
Why don't you ever correct me? You're terrible. I've been saying it the whole time.
That's okay. Maybe it said nitrate. I don't know. It just is spelled nitrite.
Ugh. Continue.
Whatever. We can't pronounce half the words in this game. You guys work for a horrible boss. I met that guy. Wouldn't the world be better off without him? Well, you're not going to try to kill him.
Actually, it wouldn't.
And you're right. We're not cops, but we understand that they have a very easy to dial phone number. Yes.
No.
Stop for like 2 seconds.
Award-winning cake.
Turns out that Lana's smurfy disposition, another smurf.
Yep, another smurf.
Is in fact a result of sodium nitrate poisoning.
I have been saying nitrate and I know it.
I know you have. So Russell did put it in her food. Oh yeah. You would shut up about it when Starsky and Butch were finished with him. Butch? Okay.
I missed, if that was supposed to be clever, I missed it.
Starsky and Butch? Anyway, here's what happened. It's a no-brainer, really. Russell poisoned the French fries that she ate that day with the undyed sodium nitrate.
Wouldn't that taste horrible? I don't know, but...
I don't know. Since Lana's an alcoholic, she doesn't have enough salt in her blood, so she habitually adds it to her food. As a result, she consumed a truckload of sodium nitrate. Which was the white powder Claire saw at Lana's workstation.
That's why Russell tried to cover up his tracks by claiming it was cocaine. That guy lied so much about so many things. It was like all these diversions. And then he cleaned up her work area so he wouldn't find anything.
Threw away the Danishes.
Danish.
Exactly. After gulping down enough sodium nitrite to kill a bull elephant, he turned her skin transparent. The high levels of meth goblins in Lana's blood surged through her body. Ooh. The cool zoom-in CG effects are not quite the same here.
Not quite working.
So much for the budget. causing her blood to go from being red to that nice Milky Way brown color. And giving her that Blue Man Group look the guys find so attractive. That's two Blue Man Group references.
Dabba-dee-dabba-die.
20 Smurf references.
I have a girlfriend, and she is so blue.
And since Lana liked Eiffel 65, Wilson's disease with P6PD deficiency, the methylene blue didn't cure her meth goblins.
It put her into hemolytic crisis instead.
Put Lana on a plasma exchange. Start her on penicillamine to help with the excess copper in her system. She's to start improving and rejoining the land of the non-blue after a few days. The land of the non-blue. That's real creative.
You can be Chase here. Good luck.
Blue potatoes, blue cheese dressing.
You have to be Australian.
I can't Australiate.
Think about Crocodile Dundee, because that's realistic.
I sense a theme at work here. I can't do it, sorry.
Well, I have to give it to House. He made good on his word. This is one swank meal. That's not blue, it's purple. I don't know.
And finally, a restaurant where the chef isn't afraid to use a decent amount of salt. Ha! Ha!
I'm a horrible person, aren't I?
Yeah?
Well, you are a little bit repulsive, Lana. Come on, Claire, cut the crap. One of my employees tried to poison me. I'm the worst boss ever.
That's a good way to think about it.
I would absolutely agree with that.
I mean, that's kind of true.
You can be a bit brusque. I'm not saying that what... I suddenly lost all of my motor skills and can no longer talk. Sorry, everyone.
Just make fart sounds for the whole rest of this.
Yeah, he thinks he's such a gourmet. Wonder how long, how he likes the slop they serve in prison.
Exactly.
Exactly. But you could maybe be a bit nicer to the employees, you know, treat them like human beings. I dyed my hair. You're right. From now on, I'll be nicer to you. To whoever the hell is taking Russell's place. To everybody.
And then his heart grew two sizes. No, anyway.
Once you turn blue, you... I don't know, everything, your whole life changes.
Once you turn blue, you're a new you.
Ooh, ah, I like it. Yeah, yeah, terrific. Now, could you get off your ass and give me the damn cayenne pepper? I mean, Claire, dear, won't you please pass me the cayenne pepper? Thanks ever so much.
But this is like such...
How's that?
Entire scene would never happen in the show. They just never ever like revisit and show them afterward like that.
Right,
if anything, it's a collage, but not like this. This is like a, and here's what happened. Ugh, what was that?
That's at the end, I guess.
Why
I
did
got
it
an
show...
A minus?
Oh, I guess we're in Cuddy's office. Is that why it showed her door?
Yeah, I guess so, because she gives you the final grade, and so I got... I don't know what the minus is, or why I got the A minus in Globetrotting, either. I don't know if you remember the previous chapter all that much, but there were
barely
different things you had to do at the end. Like, do you remember the breakout game at the end, where he has, like, an epiphany, and you're in his brain, and you're playing? So that wasn't in this one, there were different things, and I think there's some different things in the upcoming chapters.
There's a lot of things we missed in this one, like, you know, asking the wrong questions, or, you know, not doing perfectly in the mini games and things like that.
So I did good.
You did well enough. I mean, it was an A minus. It could have been a B.
Oh, man, if this were me... Well, it is me, but if this were... Guys,
it is you.
I have something to tell you.
Wait, is this your weird boobs talking again or something? Is this not actually...
Yeah, you know how Ace Ventura made his ass talk? You just make your cleavage talk that way. It's no different.
Okay.
And thus, I've made cleavage unattractive for everyone now by comparing it to a butt. You're welcome. You're welcome.
That's not the
stigma
worst.
Is gone. Cleavage is just a butt crack. That's all it is.
Well, or butts are just, you know,
that's
cleavage
something,
for your back.
That's something to sit on. Get it? Because butt.
Back cleavage, you know? It's arguable.
Well, I forgot what I was going to say now. I was going to say if this were me, like, academically, like, if these were my actual grades, I'd be incredibly depressed. I'm one of those people. I don't get A minuses. I get A's and A pluses, and there's A minus. That's too close to a B.
Well, thankfully, this is not academic. This is just saving lives, so whatever.
Thank God.
As long as the lives are saved, then who cares?
Exactly.
That's the theme of House. You know, the ends justify the means, and whatever. You know, the person isn't dead, so it was worth it.
I did it. We did it. High five, Clint. Ugh.
Yay.
That wasn't real. I just clapped.
I just slapped my chest. That was a really weak episode
for
a House episode. That was really pretty bad. Like, there was nothing particularly weird about it, like, at all. I guess maybe even the epiphany was really weak.
It's
like, oh, yeah, he just poisoned her. What? I guess. I don't know.
It's not meant to be an episode, you know?
No, it is! They build this as, like, being a playable version of the TV show, and it's, like, one of those weird guest director episodes where everything is for some reason. It's like, well, why did the art style change in the... You know, and it's one of those episodes.
The question is, how does this compare to other licensed game in this vein? You know, we have, like, CSI, Grey's Anatomy.
Thankfully, I haven't played any of those.
Murder, She Wrote.
One of the few that I've got any experience with,
okay,
because I avoid them so badly. What do you think?
I play a lot of licensed games, as you know. I always have. I've always played a lot of licensed game. There's something intriguing about them. And to be quite honest, if I were to criticize it, this is one of the better ones. to be very honest with you, this has, even though they're very simple, the mini games are a little bit better. There's variation in what you do. There's interrogation when you talk to people. There's mini games. There's medical like process. It's and those things are kind of like life and death. So it's got a little bit of charm to it. I wouldn't say it's accurate in terms of the show. It's close. It does an okay job. But as
it
far
does
as license,
an okay job. Yeah. But yeah, it's better than Miami Vice for DOS. So.
Right. Oh yeah. Everything. I mean, that's not hard. That's not hard to be better than Miami Vice.
Really not.
But that's, I mean, it is okay. You know what I mean? It's not, I've definitely have licensed game reviews on my channel that are far worse. Far worse and, you know, than this. I do have a little bit of a problem with the writing, as I mentioned before. It's just all cutting with no punchline. You know, it's just kind of trying way too hard to be, I guess, offensive. And it's working because it's just like meh. Like it's kind of just kind of bothersome, honestly. Like you said earlier, it's just bothersome.
It is, yeah. Some of it is just it's way off, trying too hard, or being like, just going from being cutting or like, oh man, can't believe you said that, to wow, I really like that's just off-putting.
Yeah, it's off-putting. That's a good
know?
Word for it. It's off-putting.
It's just like as opposed to, you know, a lot of times in house, it's like, oh man, oh that's so true, but man, that was a, you know, very tactless way to say it.
No, it's kind of like if I called you like a loser or stupid, and then I expect you to laugh, like it's some kind of joke,
bit.
You know.
Yeah, I don't know. It seems to be. Maybe some stuff was cut from the game or something, because it seemed like some scenes were set up to, like, something else had already happened, and we were supposed to know about it, and it's just like, well, you didn't show that, so how was I supposed to know?
That's very true.
Yeah.
But that's it. That is chapter 2 of House. There are more chapters. I don't know if I'll be doing them or not.
I'll play it again in 2016.
Probably a couple, yeah, it's been a couple of years since I did the last one. I'll probably wait a little bit more because I don't want to saturate. I wanted to wait on purpose. I didn't want to saturate my channel with more House Let's Play, but I figured it was about time. People were actually asking for it. You know, your wish is my command. You've got it. Got all kinds of things to think about now. And
yeah.
I'll let you know if I play the next one, but I'm thinking the next one will be Murder, She Wrote. I'm always open to more of these licensed video games, though, so go ahead and leave suggestions, because I do buy licensed games on purpose, and I enjoy them in a very strange way, even when they're bad. And thank you for my special guest, Lazy Game Reviews, my apparent only friend on YouTube. Everyone else ditched me. They don't want to play these games with me, but LGR does, so there you go. You get a gold star.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
So honored.
I bet. I can tell you are just had a thrilling time.
Yep.
All right. That is it for now. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for watching me. And I'll see you guys in the next one.
Bye.